Hello, welcome to Astronaut. Today we're talking about three concepts that we can use to describe lenses. So the first one is the thin lens equation, the second one is magnification, and the last one is power. So let's get into it. What is a thin lens? The thickness of a lens determines how much light entering the lens will be refracted. The thicker the lens, the more the light will be refracted. A thin lens is a lens with negligible thickness. The thin lens equation relates the distance to the object, the distance to the image, and the focal length. 1 over DO plus 1 over DI is equal to 1 over F. This ignores the optical effects that happen if we're on the surfaces of a lens because we have a thin lens. The focal distance is positive for convex lenses and negative for concave lenses. The object distance is always positive. The image distance is positive if the image is on the opposite side of the lens than the object, and it's negative if the image is on the same side as the object. We have this convention because images on the opposite side of an object are real images, and the images that are on the same side of the object when we make our depictions are virtual images. So it makes more sense for the virtual ones, the non-real ones, to be negative and real to be positive. Let's say I have a convex lens with a focus of 5 centimeters from the center of the lens. The distance to my object is twice as large, 10 centimeters. How far is the image from the lens? Well, if I plug 5 centimeters into F and 10 centimeters into DO, I find that the distance to the image is 10 centimeters. It is positive, which means that the image is on the opposite side of the lens as the object. A negative image distance indicates that the image is on the same side of the lens as the object. Another way to describe the relationship between the image and the object is through magnification. Magnification is the ratio of the height of the image to the height of the object. This is equal to the ratio of the distance to the image over the distance to the object, but negative. In our previous example, the distance to the image was 10 centimeters. The distance to the object was also 10 centimeters. Our magnification is thus negative 10 over 10, or negative 1. A ratio of 1, or a negative 1, indicates that the image is the same size as the object. The negative magnification indicates that the image is inverted. Let's run through another scenario. A concave lens has a focus at 8 centimeters and an image at negative 8 centimeters. The negative in front of the image distance suggests that it's virtual. This means the object and the image will be on the same side of the lens. What is the magnification of the image? To calculate magnification, we need either the heights or the distances of the object and the image. In this problem, we are given the distance to the image and enough information to calculate the object distance. To find the object distance, we use the thin lens equation. If we plug negative 8 centimeters into the image distance, 8 centimeters into the focal length, and do some algebra magic, we find that the object distance is 4 centimeters. Now we have enough information to find the magnification. So if I plug this into my magnification formula, I get negative 8 fourths, so just 8 fourths, is equal to 2. This means that the image is twice as large as the object. The magnification is positive, which indicates the image is right side up. If the image has a height of 6 centimeters, how tall is the object? Since the ratio of the heights is the same as the ratio of the distances, we use the magnification equation to find that the object height is 3 centimeters. The last concept we're going to use today to describe a lens is power. The power of a lens is equal to the inverse of its focus in meters. If I have a lens with a focus of 2 meters, my power is 1/2 diopters. If I have a lens with a focus at 1/2 meter, my power is 2 diopters. If I have a lens with a focus at 10 centimeters, my power is 1 over 0.1 meters, because remember this is in units of meters, is equal to 10 diopters. Diopter just means 1 over meter. The best way to understand the concepts in today's video is to solve problems yourself. So for this lesson, I'm doing something a little different. I created a worksheet with some practice problems, which you can access via the link in the description below. It's completely free, and you can check your answers with the solutions that provided, so I hope it's helpful. If you do find it helpful, please let me know, and maybe I'll make more for the future or for future lessons. But yeah, that's pretty much all for today, so I hope you understood these concepts and that the additional practice will help you understand them even better. Thanks for watching. As always, ponder, wander, and go write in the stars.